We just got done filling our water at the water filling place. Y'all have seen us here before. It's pretty much a weekly occurrence. So now we're going to go, we got some grocery shopping that we would like to do, and we thought that we would check out a different grocery store than we have been to in the past. It's in the town of Chapala, just coming into the very small community of San Juan Casala. And this is one of the towns where we have noticed some of the new kind of things. Like, for instance, we noticed a lot of new murals. You can see one of the new murals. It depicts like a guy on a bicycle. Here's another one coming up right there. Over here on the north side of the road, you can see these. These are all new concrete barricades. Further up the lake, where they've made more progress, they're planting like trees. There's like a planter in the midst of those, and this is all new bike path here east of San Juan Casala. Working on the bike path, all these guys along here. These guys on the road. This is a. Over here on this side of the road, it's very close to the lake, and there's all these restaurants along here. There's just like one right after another, and they all look to be pretty nice, with like lakeside seating. So these guys come out at the lunch and dinner time and stand on the road and try to wave you in. This is all new stuff along here. There's some more guys working on another section. Bike trail. We are coming into Ajijic and see all the cars. It just seems to be always a lot more bunched up traffic here in Ajijic. This is the place that they have given this Pueblo Magico.
Let's see what this parking's like.
Yeah. So obviously you can see what I mean here on the traffic situation. There's just a lot more traffic on the road. Here in Ajijic, there's always along the road here a lot of artisans and crafts people selling things. I just realized it is Wednesday, so there is a market that takes place. And we're coming up on it, which is why there seems to be a lot more people parked along the side of the road. There's a street, and as soon as we get up there by it, I will show you. It's near to the grocery store, one of them that we go to often. Here's one of the, since we're stopped here, I can show you the crafts people with all the hammocks and the macrame kind of stuff. Down here in Ajijic, we go a lot of times to this supermercado El Torito. That's it there. And there's the market, the street that has the market on it. It's all the way down that street, all sorts of things, vegetables and just clothing and decor, jewelry, handicrafts. So there's an intersection to see. It says you can turn here and go that way to Guadalajara, away from the lake. And over here is Walmart. And Dave and I have been to Walmart once. Far east of the Walmart, once you get out of Ajijic, and it's just so many businesses along here. Once again, here's the bike trail. This part was here when we got here last June. Yeah, this runs between Ajijic and Chapala. There's a pet care place. We notice a lot of pet care and veterinarians. So if you've got a pet, you know, you're gonna have no problem finding a vet or like pet supplies. Bike path still running along here. We're still between Ajijic and Chapala. Now we are coming into Chapala area. There's another dog, pet grooming, everything for your pet place. That place has a cool elevator. See that? There's the bus station. Pretty much much get on a bus and go to just about anywhere in Mexico just from right there. Yeah, we found the Soriana. And here we are. Okay, you ready for this?
Ready to go.
Hola.
Hola.
Ooh, look at that, pure butter. So that's sometimes hard to find here.
What's the unsalted?
Sin sal, means no salt. And they are 44 pesos each. So that's like about $2, a little over $2. I am in the cleaning aisle because I need a couple of new towels, like for kind of light towels. These ones here look pretty good. This store has a lot more than just food. Like, we got mattresses here, bedding. There's some sewing and craft stuff. Sporting goods. Now this is the size coffee cup that I really do need, I think. This would probably be about enough. T-bone. This is 115 pesos for queso de Oaxaca, which Dave and I really like. It's like mozzarella, kind of like string cheese mozzarella. You want to get this? We have an automotive section in here. These are all the different kinds of box milk, which is something that is kind of different. I haven't ever really seen this in the United States, but yeah, lots and lots of box milk that you do not have to refrigerate. Chicken soup. Olive oil. All right, now let's figure out which one we want to get. This is right. That's what you get. Yeah, that's what you always get. Our basket's getting pretty full. All right, now we're gonna try to check out. All right, that's good.
You
did
fun.
Should have to see where my Topo Chico is. Here we are on some crazy road, just leaving the grocery store. You go that way. My gosh. Look at a donkey. Oh. Taking y'all on a walk with us around the condo community. The current trash situation at the condo is getting a bit on the piled up side. That's the first time it's been that, there's been that much. So I don't know what's going on with the garbage situation.